everyone, and welcome to Kids Rock, Rock of the Foothills online forum for Kids Church. Today we're beginning our brand new series, Thankfulness, where we will be thankful for all of the gifts that God has given us. Ever since you were a small child, your parents have taught you a simple courtesy. When someone gives you something, what two words do you say? Thank you. Those two words are drilled into our heads. We learn the words thank you almost as fast as we learn mom, dad, and no. Saying thank you is a common courtesy we extend to everyone, from the people who serve us in restaurants to our grandparents. We expect it when we do something nice for someone else, but how often do we mean it? Is saying thanks just something we do out of habit? Or do we really mean it when we say thank you? When we stop to think about the things we have been given and the givers of those gifts, we have much to be thankful for. And in the next few weeks, we'll talk about many of the reasons we have to be thankful and how we can best show our thanks. One of the most important things we can be thankful for is the God who created us. God made each one of us unique. He gave us the family He did in the place and time He did for a specific reason. God knew each of us before we were ever born, and He planned for us to be right where we are, right now, so that He could use us to show the world His amazing love. In today's scripture, we're going to meet a man who learned firsthand how God makes each one of us for a special purpose. The man's name was Jeremiah, and he was amazed to discover that God had a special purpose for his life. Jeremiah didn't believe it at first, but with God's direction, he became one of the most important men in the Old Testament. Today's scripture comes from the book of Jeremiah. If you have a Bible at home, go ahead and grab it so you can follow along. We're going to be reading from the Old Testament, the book of the prophet of Jeremiah. We're going to be in the first chapter, and we're going to read verses 4 through 19. A message came to me from the Lord. He said, "Before I formed you in your mother's body, I chose you. Before you were born, I set you apart to serve me. I appointed you to be a prophet to the nations. You are my Lord and King," I said. "I don't know how to speak. I am only a child." But the Lord said to me, "Do not say I'm only a child. You must go to everyone I send you to. You must say everything I command you to say. Do not be afraid of the people I send you to. I am with you. I will save you," announces the Lord. Then the Lord reached out his hand. He touched my mouth and spoke to me. He said, "I have put my words in your mouth. Today I am appointing you to speak to the nations and kingdoms. I want you to pull them up by the roots and tear them down. I want you to destroy them and crush them, but I also want you to build them up and plant them." A message came to me from the Lord. He asked me, "What do you see, Jeremiah?" "The branch of an almond tree," I replied. The Lord said to me, "You have seen correctly. I am watching to see that my word comes true." Another message came to me from the Lord. He asked me, "What do you see?" "A pot that has boiling water in it," I answered. "It's leaning toward us from the north." The Lord said to me, "Something very bad will be poured out on everyone who lives in this land. It will come from the north. I am about to send for all of the armies in the northern kingdoms," announces the Lord. "Their kings will come to Jerusalem. They will set up their thrones at the very gates of the city. They will attack on the walls that surround the city. They will go to war against all of the towns of Judah. I will judge my people. They have done many evil things. They have deserted me. They have burned incense to other gods. They have worshipped the gods their own hands have made. So get ready. Stand up. Tell them everything I command you to. Do not let them terrify you. If you do, I will terrify you in front of them. Today I have made you like a city that has a high wall around it. I have made you like an iron pillar and a bronze wall. Now you can stand up against the whole land. You can stand against the kings and officials of Judah. You can stand against its priests and its people. They will fight against you, but they will not overcome you. I am with you. I will save you, announces the Lord. Jeremiah came along at a time in history when God's chosen people, Israel, had forgotten him. God had saved Israel from slavery. He had given them a land to call their own and protected them from all enemies. Yet the people rejected God and chose to worship false gods instead. God had warned the people long ago that he would punish them if they ever forgot him. God needed a man to remind Israel of that warning. Someone brave and bold who would share God's message without fear. God chose Jeremiah for that very reason. Jeremiah didn't believe he had it in him to be a prophet. But when the judgment for their sin came, it was Jeremiah who reminded the people why they were being punished and showed them the way they could repent of their sin. God made each of us for a special purpose, just as he did Jeremiah. We need to thank God for the gifts he's given us, and we need to use our gifts to show the world God loves us. Now let's check out today's craft. For our thankfulness series, we are going to do a thankful tree where every week we will be writing something different that we are thankful for. To make your thankful tree, you're going to need a vase, and I put some rocks inside that will hold our sticks. These are just some white decorative rocks that I had around the house. I went outside and we have an oak tree at my house, and I was able to pick some sticks off of the oak tree, so I'm going to put them inside our rocks. See how they just kind of hold them up? So I've got some pretty big sticks here that have all different types of all different things sticking out from them so that we can stick our leaves onto our tree. So Cambria has already started to write some things onto her leaves. Cambria, what gifts and talents are you thankful for?
I'm thankful for singing and the art and books.
Very good. Well, to make your leaf, what you're gonna do is you're gonna take a colorful piece of paper, yellow, orange, red, brown, any one of those beautiful fall colors.
We chose yellow.
Yes, we did. And we're gonna cut out kind of an oval, but your leaves could be circles. If you have a template, maybe you could do like a maple leaf or any kind of other leaf, but we're just gonna do a simple oval leaf, punch a hole. And then I'm gonna put, I had some yarn lying around from my knitting. And so I cut some of that off to make the loop to hang it on our tree. Now let's see, what gift am I thankful for? Well, I am so thankful that I can be here to teach you, friends. So the gift that I am thankful for is teaching. And we are gonna put all of our gifts and talents up on our thankful tree. So here we go. Pick a branch, Cambria. Would you like some help?
Yes, please.
All right. I'll put singing up over here. And we'll put books right here. Yay. And every week, we will be adding new things that we are thankful for to our tree. When we receive a gift, the first words after we say, wow, and just what I wanted, should always be thankful. As we discover the gifts God has given us, we need to thank him as well. When we discover a talent we have for something like music or drama, we can thank God. When we discover a passion we have, something we enjoy doing that serves others, we can thank God as well. God loves to hear our prayers, and He really loves when we are thankful. But saying thank you isn't enough. If we say thank you for a gift and we put it in the closet, what good is that gift to us or anyone else? God wants us to show we are thankful by putting our gifts and talents to use. Those who can sing for God. Those with a talent for leading others and teaching should do what God made them to do. And those who have a gift of encouragement should always be on the lookout for someone who needs a pick-me-up. It's worth pointing out that God doesn't expect us to wait until we are older to use those gifts. Remember when Jeremiah thought he was too young? God told Jeremiah his age didn't matter. God can use you even though you are still kids to bless others. So don't put off using your gifts for God. God can use anyone, even kids, to show people He loves them. God didn't give us gifts for the simple pleasure of seeing us discover them. He wants us to use the gifts to be a part of His plan to bring salvation to the world. Just as God used Jeremiah to warn the people and show them the way back to Him. God can use us to invite our friends and others to meet Jesus in person. Let us give thanks to God every day in prayer for the things He has given us. And let us show Him how thankful we are by putting those gifts to work so others can give thanks to God as well. Thanks and glory be to God who gave us His Son and so much more. Now it's time for our questions. And remember, you can pause the video at any time to give you more time to talk about it as a family. Our first question is, what did God call Jeremiah to do? And what excuses did Jeremiah give? Our next question is, what is one talent or gift God has given you that you are thankful for? And our last question is, how can you show God that you are thankful by using that gift for Him? Let's pray. Dear God, please reveal the gifts and talents that you have given to each of us. We want to thank you for these wonderful gifts, God, that make us so unique and special to you. Help us to use these gifts to glorify your holy and precious name. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. All right, friends, that's it for today. We'll see you again next time for some more Kids Rock. Bye!